following is a sports presentation of WGN America.
Scorching hot late Saturday afternoon here at Wrigley Field, and we're set for Chicago Cubs baseball on WGN Sports. The Cubs entertain the Houston Astros today as we welcome Cub fans from all over the country watching on WGN America, America's home for baseball. And hi again, everyone. Along with Bob Brenly, I'm Len Casper. It's going to be tough to stay cool today. Wind blowing out as Matt Garza will face Jay Happ. More on the pitchers coming up. But, Bob, it's been a good homestand. The Cubs 3-1. They've had three really good ones, one bad one.
We'll take that anytime. 3 out of 4. And the pitching has really been the key to the entire homestand so far. Travis Wood with a great start on Monday against Johan Santana. We're highlighting Anthony Rizzo on Tuesday because it was his Cubs debut, but 6 innings of shutout baseball from the bullpen in that game. Jeff Samardzija with a stumble on Wednesday and then a real good ball game again yesterday.
Yeah, 4-0 the final as Paul Mahalam went into the ninth. It would be nice to see Matt Garza do that, and he's been a lot better at Wrigley than on the road.
I think both pitchers today have been a lot better at home than on the road. And Matt Garza here at home, 1-1 record with a 3.36 ERA. The numbers on the road not nearly as pretty, including getting banged around in Houston against the Astros last time.
Question for Jay Happ is he on the road? He went to Northwestern. He's from Peru, Illinois.
Well, he can try to convince himself of that fact, but the schedule says this is a road game. We're hoping for the numbers on the right.
All right, some lefties in the lineup today against Happ. We'll tell you about that when we come back. The Cubs yesterday used the home run ball to support Paul Mahalam as Valbuena, Clevinger with the first of his career, and Soriano finding Waveland. We'll have game two of this series next.
The verdict is in, America. There's a lot of mother lovers out there.
No.
Yes.
You've tweeted.
I like you.
You've posted.
They love me.
And you've watched HIMYM on WGNA.
That's just awesome.
With fans this amazing, we'd just like to say...
Thank you!
Watch How I Met Your Mother and Meet at McLaren's to join the legendary conversation.
Hey, can you hold that, please?
All right. Here we go.
Keep the change.
Just over 9 minutes to go.
Hello, Elijah.
Me too. How are you?
It's the sure sign of a good time. The just right taste of Bud Light. Here we go.
Apparently, I didn't get the Thong Thursday memo.
Mesothelioma victims and their loved ones may be entitled to a cash award from the $18 billion in asbestos trust funds, and you do not have to file a lawsuit. If diagnosed with mesothelioma or lung cancer caused by exposure to asbestos, call the number on your screen now. Even if a loved one had mesothelioma or asbestos lung cancer and has passed, your family may still be entitled to a cash award. Mesothelioma is a rare cancer caused by exposure to asbestos. Many victims worked in the Navy or in shipyards, mills, carpentry, roofing, insulation, construction, or automotive industries. For over 30 years, our legal team has successfully helped thousands of victims and families. Time is limited. You do not have to file a lawsuit. If you or a loved one has been diagnosed with mesothelioma or lung cancer caused by exposure to asbestos, please call 1-800-296-1976 now. That's 1-800-296-1976.
Chicago Cubs baseball brought to you by Bud Light. It's the sure sign of a good time. Here we go. Pepsi Max, the official soft drink of Major League Baseball. Zero calories, maximum Pepsi taste. The Illinois Lottery. Do you believe in the power of possibility? The Illinois Lottery. Anything's possible. and by Ford, manufacturers of more fuel-efficient vehicles than any other brand. Check them out at your local Ford store or online at localfordstores.com. Chicago Cubs baseball in high definition is brought to you by Xfinity, your home for the most live sports.
Today's game is available in Spanish on your SAP audio setting provided by WRTO La Tremenda, Chicago's Spanish language sports leader.
Let's get the Houston Astros starting lineup written out by Brad Mills. No runs on four hits yesterday. Schaefer leads off in center. Jed Lowry with his first start in this series. 14 home runs already. Carlos Lee all over the trade rumor headlines. More on that coming up. Bogusevic in right. Chris Johnson at third. Jason Castro's a catcher. You have J.D. Martinez in left. Former Cubs Scott Moore at second. And Jay Happ, the pitcher.
And let's check out how the Cubs take the field defensively this afternoon behind starter Matt Garza, brought to you by Pepsi Max, the official soft drink of Major League Baseball. Zero calories, maximum Pepsi taste. Soriano, DeJesus, and LaHare left to right across the outfield. It'll be Valbuena, Castro, Barney, and Rizzo third to first across the infield. Giovanni Soto doing the catching today for right-hander Matt Garza. His overall numbers on the season, I mentioned a start against Houston last month on the 21st, went only three innings, gave up five hits and seven earned runs in that ball game. The home run ball was a big factor that afternoon.
Laz Diaz behind the plate, Everett Schreiber and Welke around the bases. Matt is 0-3 in five career starts against the Astros as Schaefer shows bunt, takes ball one. And we're underway. -92 sizzling degrees as we get started. Believe it or not, Bob, we have an east wind at 4 miles an hour. It was blowing straight out earlier. Really, the flags not doing a whole lot at the moment.
I mean, if batting practice was any indication, the wind will have zero effect on batted balls. If anything, it may help balls hit toward left field.
So it is hot. Not terribly muggy. Humidity 51%. It's been a lot worse here in Chicago at times, that's for sure. Garza's 1-2 is a riser, 2-2. Schaefer hit eight yesterday, 1-for-3. In the leadoff spot this afternoon, takes that one inside to fill it up at 3-2.
Just off the inside corner with that cut fastball. Schaefer's a good guy to keep off the bases. The Astros don't run a lot, but he is one of their primary sources of speed with 18 stolen bases on the season.
Mentioned 0-3, including that loss on May 21st. He's had an interesting month. He's only won one game here in June, but he's gone at least six innings and has allowed no more than three earned runs in any of his five June starts. There's a pop up off of third, and Valbuena quickly running out of room. Don't think it took either starter too long to get loose on a day like this.
And it probably won't take either starter too long to get fatigued on an afternoon like this. You really love to keep that pitch count down early in the ball game.
A lot of guys will bring out bottles of water for a batting practice. Darwin Barney had like a gallon jug of water.
Stay hydrated. Yep.
Line foul to the pull side. Good barehanded play by the bullpen catcher. Now outside and a leadoff walk. By the way, it was Javier Bracamonte, one of the Astros bullpen catchers. They don't get enough credit.
Yeah, they got one guy down in that bullpen, Stretch Suba. Is technically called a bullpen assistant. He's been with the Astros organization for 35 years. Wakes up in the morning, puts his shin guards on. That's Stretch with the red top on and the shin guards and the shades.
Andy Lane, Cubs bullpen catcher, does a great job. Franklin Font, member of the coaching staff, who also catches out in the bullpen.
And you know who appreciates those guys more than anybody else is the day's backup catcher. In case of today's game, that's Steve Clevenger. At the minor league level, the backup catcher on his days off goes to the bullpen and catches pitchers all day. In the big leagues, you've got bullpen catchers to take that load.
Switch hitting Jed Lowry, having an all-star type first half. They got him from Boston over the winter. 14 home runs, leads the Astros, leads all major league shortstops, as does his .494 slugging percentage. He's on pace to shatter the single season club record for a shortstop. Looked like Schaefer was leaning. Dickie Thon hit 20 homers 1983 for the Astros.
Boy, Dickie Thon was well on his way to becoming a fixture at shortstop on the National League All-Star team for years, and then a horrific beaning. I believe it was Mike Torres hit Dickie Thon in the face with a pitch, and he was never the same after that.
We probably won't see Jose Altuve, their starting second baseman. He leads all National League second basemen with a .309 average. In this series, if anything, he would pinch hit, but he's dealing with a strained hamstring and hasn't played since last Sunday.
We're looking at Jed Lowry as he takes his stance in that left-handed batter's box. It's so odd to see somebody use a closed stance. Over time, batters in the box have evolved to the point where just about everybody is either square with their setup or slightly open with that front foot. But Lowry, a little old school there, goes with the closed stance.
Well, this is another one of those days, especially as we get into the late afternoon hours. Right field's going to be a tough sun field, but it's so hot, you have that slight feel of haze. And you don't want to take your eye off a pop-up today. Just off the outside corner as he tried to paint a fastball. 1-2.
It looked good because Giovanni Soto was set up out there, but that pitch is well off the outside corner, just trying to get Lowry to chase something, hit an easy ground ball.
Carlos Lee on deck. Been pretty close over there, and Bobby Meacham talking with Mike Everett. Is he wondering if Garza's balking?
Yeah, it looks like he's talking about the way Matt Garza takes that one last cleansing breath before he delivers the ball to home plate. The rule book specifically states that you can't call a balk for breathing. It is a very exaggerated deep breath by Matt Garza.
Runner goes, pitch was in the dirt. The throw, however, right on the money. What a play by Soto.
Well, that's one as a catcher where you just take a chance. That ball's in the dirt. If you try to block it, you're going to have no chance to get the base runner. So Gio just does the best he can, picks that ball cleanly out of the dirt. The strong throw to Castro. And Schaefer is gunned down at second base.
Meantime, 2-2 on Lowry. Outside, and it's full, 3-2. Not only was that pitch in the dirt, Bob, but it was a 77-mile-an-hour curveball. So he had two things going against him, and he still got him. I'll give Garza credit. He threw over there a few times, maybe shaving a half step off Schaefer's lead. Fly ball left field, right down the line, and it's going to be Soriano to make the grab. Two down.
Time to look at today's Mazda drive to victory, and what the Cubs need to do today is get it right against the lefties. The Cubs are only 4-17 against left-handed starters this year. Need to change those numbers against J-Hap today. And for the Astros, darling, you got to let me know, should I stay or should I go? It's reported that the Dodgers and the Astros have a deal in place for Cliff Lee, or rather Carlos Lee, and just waiting his approval. Drive to victory brought to you by your local Chicagoland Mazda dealers. See your Chicagoland Mazda dealer for a test drive today at driveamazda.com.
He has veto power to say yay or nay. Has a cattle ranch in the Houston area, which may make him not want to leave the Astros this summer. He's a free agent after the season. But it has been very widely reported that the Dodgers and Astros very serious about a potential trade. Dodgers are looking for some offense. They got shut out again last night. Garza will toss it over to Rizzo, and the inning is over. Leadoff walk, no runs. Cubs coming up. I wish that I could have this moment for life.
National hot dogs are so amazingly good, you'll get lost in an all-beef hot dog world. What was I supposed to wish for? Why am I wearing a bow tie? Where did I leave my bicycle? After all, when you're enjoying the beefiest, juiciest bite of pure kosher beef, nothing else matters. Goodness gracious, that's kosher. With no fillers, byproducts, artificial flavors, or colors. Hebrew National, the better than a hot dog hot dog.
You want to save money on car insurance? No problem. You want to save money on RV insurance? No problem. You want to save money on motorcycle insurance? No problem. You want to find a place to park all these things? Forget about it. This is New York.
Hey, little guy, wake up!
Oh, come off it, mate.
Geico. Saving people money on more than just car insurance.
Now Dale Swaim's Pepsi lineup for today's game against the Astros, brought to you by Pepsi Max, the official soft drink of Major League Baseball. Zero calories, maximum Pepsi taste. They're facing a lefty, but you see DeJesus, Rizzo, and LeHair near the top, and Luis Valbuena. So a bunch of lefties in there against the southpaw.
Take a look at the Astros defensively. J.D. Martinez in left, Jordan Schaefer in center, Brian Bogusevic in right field. It'll be Chris Johnson, Jed Lowry, Scott Moore, and Carlos Lee, third to first across the infield. Jason Castro doing the catching today for left-hander Jay Happ. See his numbers on the season. A four-pitch mix from Happ: fastball, curveball, slider, changeup. He's been really good his last couple of timeouts. Two victories over the Royals and the Indians. Surrendered only three runs in 13 innings of total work.
He has been better against lefties than righties, but the split isn't as drastic as is the case for a lot of left-handers. So DeJesus in there, and Anthony Rizzo at this point is going to play every day regardless. Brian LeHair also getting a start in right. And a tall lefty with an 0-1. That caught the outside corner. Nothing in two quickly.
Well, even though he is a lefty, Happ doesn't have a lot of deception in his delivery. Very upright, over-the-top delivery, especially with that fastball. Very true. Some lefties that throw from that low three-quarters arm angle have a lot of funk in their delivery, a lot of movement on their pitches. Hap, not so much.
A lot of family and friends in attendance today. Said he's from Peru, Illinois, about 100 miles west-southwest of Chicago. He attended Northwestern. And he strikes out DeJesus. You want to let our AT&T U-verse viewers in Chicago and around the country on WGN America know that during every Cubs home game this season, if you go to channel 780 or high definition channel 1780, you can see a special multi-view presentation that shows you all our different live camera angles here at Wrigley. It's pretty cool. So if you want to direct the game along with Skip Ellison, give a look to AT&T U-verse channel 780 or HD channel 1780.
Hey, you talked about those splits for Hap, Len. Right-handed batters hitting 280 against him this season with 11 home runs and considerably more at bats, but lefties hitting 275. So that's why you see more lefties in the Cubs lineup today, not the drastic splits that we're used to seeing facing a left-handed starter.
1-1 to Castro with Rizzo on deck. Yeah, Hap also makes his offseason home here in Chicago. So probably got to sleep in his own bed last night. But he is wearing the road uniform, as Bob astutely pointed out in the open.
Can't slip that by me. I noticed right away.
Third round pick of the Phillies in 2004. Astros got him in 2010. In the Roy Oswalt deal. Make sure you keep in touch. LennonBob@Tribune.com is our email. And you can also jump on our Facebook and Twitter pages as well. Ball four. We've seen Castro take a few walks here this week, even though he hasn't picked up a ton of hits. That's a good way for a good hitter to stay out of extended slumps. He's 2-for-14, but does have 3 walks on the homestand.
And has put himself in some real good hitters counts.
Anthony Rizzo. A walk, but 0-for-3 officially yesterday in the series opener. High for ball one. You know, if these two guys stay in their slots in the Cubs lineup, I have a feeling Anthony Rizzo is going to be batting a whole bunch with Starlin Castro at first base.
Which, if you're a left-handed hitter, you have to love that hole on the right side of the field. Although Rizzo not strictly a pull hitter, but knows how to take advantage of weaknesses in the defense. Well, one thing you have to love about Rizzo already, Lenny, he's just not in a hurry to get his at-bat over with. He's willing to take pitches. Never faced J. Happ before, obviously, so he wanted to get a couple looks at his arm angle, see what the pitch looked like coming out of his hand. Just doesn't feel like he's in any hurry to get his at-bat over with.
Well, Rizzo making his Cubs debut this week, and big day today as the Cubs announced they have agreed to terms with Cuban-born outfielder Jorge Soler, a 9-year major league contract, 20 years old. He's going to play right field to start his minor league career. He will report to Mesa for a personal spring training in July over the next few days. 3-2 on Rizzo. Soler listed at 6'3", 205 pounds.
Don't get picked off. You have to assume Castro is going to be running on the 3-2 pitch to Rizzo. Well, maybe not.
Called strike three on a fastball. Rizzo thought it might be ball four. Let's listen to Jed Hoyer, Cubs executive vice president and general manager, on how far away Jorge Soler might be from the bigs.
Let's get him in some games first. But, you know, he's 20 years old. And, you know, we're really impressed with the looks we got in games. You know, one thing that his agents did a very good job of is they put him in a lot of games down in the Dominican. It wasn't just kind of a showcase thing. They were able to play in a lot of games and he performed. So, you know, we're hopeful that's a harbinger of good things, but it's hard to tell until he gets in games.
Is it kind of hard to create?
That's Jed Hoyer on Soler. Well, the journey begins.
That's what it is, too. For most guys, it's a journey. Going to report to Mesa, Arizona initially, as you said, for kind of a accelerated spring training, get him up to speed, not only physically, but get him used to his new surroundings and his new coaches and teammates. Ultimately, will be incorporated into the Cubs minor league system at some point when they feel he's ready to go out and begin an assignment. And hopefully the journey won't be too long.
Cubs haven't put a ball in play yet. Two strikeouts and a walk here in the first. And 2-1 on Soriano. Hit another homer yesterday. Was his 15th since May 15th. Had 15 homers his last 6 weeks. This was one of the more impressive ones we've seen.
Yeah, I don't think it stopped rolling yet, Len. He absolutely clubbed this ball out onto Waveland Avenue. You can see the reaction. I love the reaction of Chris Snyder behind the plate. He just turned around and faced the backstop. He knew where that one was headed.
He hit 7 in May. He's got 8 here in June. First time he's hit at least 7 in consecutive months since 2006 when he was with Washington. 2-2, swung on and missed. Happ with 3 Ks in the inning. Cubs strand 1, scoreless after 1.
This is Mike. Mike's being healthy and chewing like a man. Introducing one-a-day Vitacraves for men. It's a gummy multivitamin with more vitamin B to convert food to energy and help Mike
do manly things like wrestle bears and take out the garbage.
New one-a-day Vitacraves for men.
Every Domino's sandwich is made fresh with only our best ingredients.
They're not simply toasted. They're baked all the way through our pizza oven.
This isn't just an oven. It's our secret ingredient.
This is a 300,000 BTU flavor fusing monster.
I think he's gone a little crazy with that oven.
The oven's special, but it's not as amazing as our Philly cheesesteak or chicken mango habanero sandwiches.
It makes my mouth water right now, actually.
Order any of our oven-baked sandwiches or medium two-topping pizzas. Choose any two for just $5.99 each.
The American Garage, the temple of the tune-up, the Taj Mahal of overhaul. More of them count on AutoZone parts than ever before. But parts are just part of what we do. Our trusted advice and helping hands approach is everywhere. So, whether it's his place, her place, or the pro's place, parts are just part of what we do.
Get in the zone.
AutoZone.
With the Capital One Cash Rewards card, you get a 50% annual bonus. And everyone likes 50% more cash. Well, except her. Go! But I'm about to change that.
Every little baby wants 50% more cash.
Fine, you try.
The Capital One Cash Rewards Card. The card for people who want 50% more cash.
What's in your wallet? What's in your...
The Cubs take on the Braves in Atlanta, Wednesday night at 7 East.
Drinksessory meets fantasy with a new chocolate chip frappe from McDonald's. Try a small for just $2.69. Many locations open 24 hours. Prices and participation may vary. Limited time offer. Hi.
Final day of June. Matt Garza against Brian Bogusevic. Called strike. De La Salle Institute alum. 1-1. Playing right. Chris Johnson, Jason Castro to follow here in the Houston second. Curveball missed. 2-1. In terms of the standings, modest goals at this point in the season for the Cubs, but they are 4.5 behind Houston for fifth. Starting play today in on the hands of Bogusevic. And Garza will underhand that one to Rizzo. So Matt has had two chances on defense and made both easily. Hey, fans, don't miss the action as the Cubs wrap up the series with the Astros tomorrow here at Wrigley Field. Game time is 1:20, but be sure to arrive early. The first 10,000 fans will receive special Cubs custom earbuds, compliments of Pepsi. For more information and to purchase tickets, visit Cubs.com. Wandy Rodriguez and Travis Wood. Tomorrow afternoon. We like to joke, Wandy has it in his contract that he always has to face the Cubs. Whenever these two teams match up. What's he going to do next year when they're in the American League? Mm.
Two lefties going tomorrow. Seems like it would be a better giveaway to have left-handed scissors tomorrow. Might be a little dangerous, but
I'm guessing they don't give away scissors too often at a ballpark or anywhere for that matter. Castro will throw. Safe. Looked like Mike Everett was ready to ring him up, but Johnson just beat it out for an infield hit there first.
Yes, a little stumble by Castro that time as he went to the hole to backhand that ball. Looked like as he attempted to plant his foot right there, he lost his footing just enough. He had to replant. Oh, man. Like they had him anyway over there at first base. Strong throw by Castro. Great stretch by Rizzo to get out there. Very close.
Almost simultaneously. And as we ponder a parallel universe in which replay would be used on a play like that, my guess would be it would be inconclusive.
Yeah.
It's just a guess.
And that's fine. I mean, you know, we saw very quickly. We saw three or four different angles. It was still too close to make a call, so you move along. Call stands on the field.
Jason Castro rolls one to Barney. Flip to Starlin Castro. They turn it 4-6-3 to end the inning. Still scoreless early on from Wrigley.
High five, America, because we're giving you great comedy 5 days a week.
5 days a week.
5 days a week.
Why, that deserves
the highest of fives.
So when you think America, think five.
Come on, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.
That's great comedy.
Give me what? Five.
5 days a week.
Freeze frame high five.
All week long, right here on WGN America.
Not leave a brother hanging. Woo!
Party started. Dolly. Pitbull together with Bud Light. Here we go.
Klondike presents 5 Seconds to Glory. Mark versus listening to his wife.
I was over at Jim and Nancy's today. Do you remember them? We had dinner with them a couple weeks ago over at Jill's house.
What would you do for a Klondike bar?
I do that too.
You've tried these?
No, just seeing how they're holding up.
It's kind of like visiting old friends. Some of them a little older than others.
You know, Wendy's has the summer berry salad. It's made fresh every day. It is so good.
Why settle when Wendy's Berry Almond Chicken Salad is made with fresh, hand-cut strawberries and plump blueberries? Fresh tastes, made fresh every day. That's Wendy's way.
Oh, that's better.
The Cubs take on the Braves in Atlanta Wednesday night at 7 East.
If you want to manage a game along with Dale Swaim, log on to WGNTV.com right now and click on the WGN Sports Game Zone banner to connect to all the up-to-the-minute stats and information while you're watching at home. Game Zone is sponsored by The Great Escape. Pools, patio sets, play sets, hot tubs, and more.
Brian LaHare playing right, batting fifth in the lineup. He'll lead off the Cubs second against Jay Happ. Fastball outside for ball one. Hasn't played a whole lot against left-handed starters. And when he has, he's struggled. And part of the idea, though, is just to give him some at-bats and hopefully he can improve. In this situation, he's 3-for-35 with one home run against left-handers.
And 20 strikeouts in 30 at-bats, yep, against left-handed pitching. Definitely have to cut that number down.
It can occasionally become a self-fulfilling prophecy in that you start the year slow like LaHare has against lefties, and then guys don't get a ton of chances to ever kind of get back in their manager's good graces in these spots.
Boy, and anytime you face Jay Happ, the key is going to be determining where the top of the strike zone is. Happ likes to work that four-seam fastball across the top of the zone, especially to the left-handed hitters. We've seen him do it repeatedly already in the first inning plus of this game.
That's a foul ball.
You don't think they'd let El Caballo put a cattle ranch on the middle of Sunset Boulevard somewhere if he went to L.A.?
He might have enough money to buy one. I'm just talking to people, you know. I mean, you look at the standings and you say, well, why wouldn't he? A chance to go to a Dodger team that has lost six in a row, but just a game out in the West. Right now, the Astros, as we mentioned, are in fifth, kind of buried in the National League Central. But, you know, Carlos Lee has gotten to a point in his career where he has earned the right to determine where he wants to play.
And a lot of times when you get to that stage of your career, you know, family matters have to be taken into consideration. Comfort level of being in Houston, a place you're very familiar with, your family is very familiar and comfortable in the area. And is it worth it to uproot them for possibly half a season as a rental player? I think most guys, however, especially a guy like Carlos Lee, realizes that that light at the end of the tunnel is beckoning, and his career will probably come to an end in the very near future, and an opportunity to possibly play in the postseason has to be very attractive.
Yep, you would think. Got him. Happ now with four strikeouts. Make sure you check out our WGN baseball blog at WGNTV.com. Brought to you by Jeff Vukovich, nationwide agent serving the area for 33 years. Contact Jeff at JeffVuk.com. Nationwide is on your side. I have a post about a couple of guys who've been lost in the shuffle here a little bit lately. Steve Clevenger and Luis Valbuena. As Giovanni Soto turns on one and rolls it into left. So Gio, who had been slumping lately, snaps an 0-for-14. You know, Luis Valbuena is only 26. I don't want to give away all the contents of the blog post, and but I will say that, you know, I'm not claiming that these two guys are going to be everyday players, but certainly usable parts, and both guys have a chance to be here for a while and getting opportunities. And along those lines, Valbuena may be getting more time than he thought. Currently at third base, Ian Stewart probably is going to be unable to avoid surgery on that troublesome left wrist. Not official yet, but it looks to be going down that road. Barney hits a fly to center. And Schaefer hauls it in for the second out.
Well, even though Valbuena had a rough day down at third base the other day, made a couple of errors on real tough chances, his value has been swinging that bat from the left side of the plate. He has made consistent, solid contact just about every time up. He's been a pleasant surprise in the power department. He just looks very comfortable swinging that bat.
One to Valbuena.
Now Valbuena with a home run to the opposite field in yesterday's ball game. I mentioned it before. He, as consistently as any Cubs hitter recently, has been getting the barrel on the ball. Even his outs have been hit hard.
Yankee right-hander Hiroki Kuroda tied a career high with 11 strikeouts, and the Yankees shut out the White Sox 4-0. So the Sox four-game winning streak is over. Dwayne Wise 3-for-3 with a home run. You know, he pitched last night in a blowout loss. Yankees will try to earn the split in that series tomorrow. Jake Peavy had 11 strikeouts but took the loss. What hasn't Dwayne Wise done? Got the hidden ball trick down. Pitched a scoreless inning and had three hits today. Pretty good week. Ground ball to Lowry. He will flip to Scott Moore to end the inning. Cubs get their first hit. No runs, however. Scoreless after two.
Sunday, your weekend time with crime continues with Law & Order Criminal Intent. Sundays at 5 East, 2 West on WGN America.
Trouble sleeping?
Do you wear a mask for your CPAP machine?
Stop using that old leaky mask. Get a new one now.
CPAP Care Club now offers replacement masks, filters, and tubing every 90 days for those on Medicare and most private insurance.
Imagine a soft, brand new nasal mask delivered right to your door just as you need it.
These new sleep masks fit great, don't leak, and are ultra comfortable.
But that's not all. CPAP Care Club will send you one of these.
My brand new face mask and my sleep apnea supplies show up right at the front door.
Wake up your partner less often with a soft, brand new mask.
With CPAP Care Club, you get all your supplies delivered to your door. We pay shipping, we work with Medicare or your insurance, and we handle the paperwork. The 30-day comfort guarantee lets you see if a new mask is right for you. Change the way you care for your sleep apnea. Call CPAP Care Club now. Shipping is free, and so is the call.
In a world where breakfast has become boring and tasteless, only one man can save the day.
A man in yellow tights.
He's nutty. He's crunchy. He is a crunchy nut. He saves the day in his tasty way.
Delicious.
Super delicious, citizen.
With his sweet and nutty, crunchy nut.
It's super delicious. The mission continues on Facebook.
Time now for our AT&T U-verse replays of the game. We go back to yesterday, Cubs 4-0 win. Big defensive play. Steve Clevenger throws out Matt Downs at third. What a play by DeJesus, pulling that one out of the vines. Ryan Bixler had a tough day as Castro and DeJesus stole away hits. See what's possible with AT&T U-verse high-speed internet. AT&T, rethink possible. They loved it.
Big fans of defense.
I want to give a couple of shout-outs today to Steve Harkins and family in town to watch the Cubs this weekend. Got a nice note from Douglas Sloan from Indianapolis, Indiana, and also Danny Mayberry from Metropolis, Illinois. Thanks for checking in. Called strike on J.D. Martinez, the left fielder, batting seven.
Get off me, ball. Wow. Martinez committed to swing at that pitch, a fastball that just continued to run further up and in, knocked the bat right out of his hands. Right about here, he realizes, man, that's a bad idea. See that flat bat out behind Martinez as he gets ready to approach the pitch. Well, we talked about Martinez's approach yesterday and how quickly he gets his front foot down on the ground, which is a key for a lot of hitting coaches. But he has a lot of movement with the bat and with his hands. So even though his foot is down, he still has a lot of movement going on from the waist up. And occasionally he's a little tardy getting that bat into a good hitting position.
And a JD and a JA, even though it goes by J, in their lineup today.
Wrigleyville Rooftops has premier seating for up to 200 guests for corporate gatherings, family reunions, and bachelor or bachelorette parties. Individual and group tickets are available for all games. For more details, go to www.wrigleyvillerooftops.com or call 773-248-ROOF.
2-2 on Julio Daniel Martinez. Comebacker and a base hit on a slider right in the middle of the zone. That's a leadoff single.
I'm sure that's not the location Matt Garza and Giovanni Soto were looking for with that slider. And I mentioned all the movement that Martinez has with his bat and his upper body, his hands, his arms, everything is moving as that pitch is being delivered. Generally, you try to work those guys up and in, figuring that it's going to be tough to get everything back into a good hitting position and get to those fastballs. We saw him get jammed badly with the second pitch of the at-bat, but an off-speed pitch out over the plate, he was right on it.
Here's a former Chicago Cubs, Scott Moore, made his debut in the big leagues with the Cubs in 2006. A couple of games in 07. He's been with the Orioles and now the Astros. Actually spent last year back in the Cubs system at AAA Iowa. Left-handed hitting infielder. This is his second major league start this year. Brought up on Tuesday from AAA Oklahoma City.
Good numbers down in AAA Okie City. Hit .318, 26 doubles, 10 homers, 54 runs batted in.
Two and one the count. Now 3-1, the pitcher Happ is on deck. Old foul, 3-2.
Well, hitting coach never mind seeing that on a 2-0 or 3-1 count. You want to see you hit that ball to your pull field with some authority, even if you happen to pull it foul. The thing the hitting coaches hate to see 2-0 and 3-1 is for a hitter to get jammed or swing late and foul the ball to his off field. You always prefer that guy to be a little out in front rather than a little behind.
That's pulled deep to right, and LeHair will have to play the bounce off the ivy. And it'll be second and third, nobody out.
Unfortunate Karam that time off the ivy and the bricks out there in right field. Scott Moore goes down and digs out a 95 mile per hour fastball. It hits the wall and ricochets back where LeHair was coming from. By the time he catches up to it, the Astros have runners at second and third.
Cubs will bring their infield in. Here's Happ, the pitcher. And a called strike. 089 in his career. He has one home run that came last year. Notice he has made a couple of pinch hit appearances this season, has three in his career. Maybe his hitting prowess is a little better than his actual numbers.
Well, he has struck out 14 times in 26 at bats. And occasionally you have to dip into your pitching staff for a pinch hitter in an extra inning ball game, or if you've got guys dinged up a little bit. So Happ must be doing something right to get the attention of his manager.
Swing and a miss. Strike three. Garza with his first strikeout. Back to the top and Schaefer.
And with Schaefer making his way to the plate, a squeeze bunt or a safety squeeze bunt is always a possibility. This is a guy that bunts for base hits quite often. It's a very natural part of his arsenal as an offensive player. And with the runner at third base, Cubs have to be aware of that.
Martinez at third, Moore at second. Nothing, nothing in the third as the Astros threaten. And in fact, threaten to get their first run of the series after being shut out yesterday.
One thing the Cubs have working in their favor in this particular situation, J.D. Martinez down there at third base, a plodding base runner. Not quick at all on his first step. Doesn't get up to top speed quickly enough to make him a threat as a base runner. Shallow fly ball to the outfield or a ground ball at one of the Cubs infielders. He's going to probably have to hold at third base.
Good curveball, and it's 0-2. He saw Dave Clark down at third. Former Cub finished his career with the Astros in 1998. You may have seen him yesterday if you were with us during our rain delay coverage. He struck out twice against Kerry Wood. There's a bouncer in the left, base hit. Martinez scores. Moore held at third, and the Astros have a 1-0 lead. That was on an 0-2 pitch.
Those guys with speed, especially left-handed hitters with speed, master this swing. Take that outside fastball, just find a hole on the left side of the infield, this time past a diving Luis Valbuena. Scott Moore, the runner at second base, had to hold to make sure that ball got through. J.D. Martinez trots home with the first run of the game.
First and third. Lowry bounces. Rizzo pick it up. Fires to the plate. Tag applied. Nicely done. Two down.
A couple of different options there for Anthony Rizzo. He could have elected to go to second base and try to initiate an inning-ending double play. But that was going to be reliant on Matt Garza getting over to cover first base. So instead, Rizzo decides to go home, cut that run off at the dish. Giovanni Soto with a nice sweep tag to get the out at the plate.
Well, the best defenders seem to just slow the game down, and there was no panic whatsoever from Rizzo on that play. First and second, here's Lee.
I think if that ball had been hit closer to first base where Rizzo felt like he could throw to second and get back and cover the bag himself, he may have elected to try to turn two, but that didn't appear to be an option, so he cut off that run at home plate instead.
Couldn't hold up, said Laz Diaz.
Mel Caballo not happy about that. All he wants is for the home plate umpire to ask for a little help from the first base umpire. We've talked about it in the past. It's an amazing multitasking ability that umpires have to watch the ball from the pitcher's hand through the hitting zone, but yet you can see the bat too. It's amazing.
Outside, Garza's missed in that area a couple of times to both lefties and righties today. Just a little bit away, 2-2.
Yeah, a little extra cheese on that fastball at 96, just off of the outside corner. Tough pitch to take.
Backs up Valbuena, sets, throws, and gets them. Astros get one. Talked to Dave Clark today, said, yeah, I caught a glimpse of what you guys were showing during your rain delay coverage. One of 20 strikeouts for Kerry Wood. Dave Clark back in 1998. Nasty.
There are two truths when it comes to baseball and car insurance. Just think 15. In baseball, it takes 15 outs to get to the middle of the third inning. And in car insurance, you could save 15% or more by switching to GEICO. All summer long, whether it's baseball on WGN America or car insurance from GEICO, the number 15 is all you need to know.
Well, kids wanted a puppy, but they can be really expensive. So to save money, I just found him a possum.
I think he's dead.
Probably just playing possum.
There he is.
There's an easier way to save. Geico. 15 minutes could save you 15% or more on car insurance.
It's a scorcher out there, folks. Stay refreshed.
Hey, boys. I have an idea.
New Lipton Tea and Honey. Sweetened with honey, made from real tea leaves and real fruit flavors.
That is so good.
Lipton Tea and Honey. Real is refreshing.
It's never.
Lipton Tea and Honey. Lipton, drink positive.
The Capital One Cash Rewards card gives you a 50% annual bonus. And who doesn't want 50% more cash? The baby. And then the baby bear said, I want 50% more cash in my bed. 50% more cash is good. What's that?
You can spell.
The Capital One Cash Rewards Card. The card for people who want 50% more cash.
What's in your wallet?
The Cubs take on the Braves in Atlanta Wednesday night at 7 East.
The 2012 Chicago Cubs baseball season on WGN-TV is brought to you by Bud Light Limerita. The ready-to-drink margarita with a refreshing twist of Bud Light Lime.
Matt Garza with his first at bat today. Finds himself trailing 1-0. Could have been a lot worse, however, as he was able to get out of the top of this inning with limited damage. Swing and a miss as Castro will get the out at first. Five strikeouts, first time through the order for Jay Happ. Early game in Toronto today. Seven runs second for the Blue Jays and an 11-2 win over the Angels. Mike Trout without a hit for the first time in 12 games. 0 for 4, still hitting .336. And you were pointing out to me before the game, nobody's really talking about Albert Pujols because he's back to the old Albert. Yeah, that's not as newsworthy, right?
No, not nearly as newsworthy, but boy, those numbers are creeping up there quickly for Big Albert. His average stands at .273. His OPS right at 800, 12 homers, 47 driven in. Starting to sound more like an Albert Pujols season.
Yep. Two and oh to DeJesus. Another homer for Trevor Plouffe as the Twins beat Kansas City 7-2. First of a day-night doubleheader in Minneapolis. Trevor Plouffe now has 16 home runs. Clubbed the Cardinals last night 14-5. Carlos Beltran got his 2000th hit in that game. Pirates leading again today 6-3 as they go to the ninth. Pedro Alvarez has hit his 15th. And Beltran with another milestone, his 400th career double this afternoon. Full count on the Cubs leadoff man, David DeJesus. Ball four. Let's step aside and see what's coming up on WGN.
When you think mother, think America. WGN America. How I Met Your Mother. Sunday starting at 7:30 East, 4:30 West on WGN America.
One on, one out. Wave, Bob. We're in the background. I think they'll catch us.
Hi.
Okay.
Yeah, some kind of telephoto lens to get us in the background of that picture.
I did the rabbit ears. Well, I mentioned the Dodgers got shut out again. 9-0 last night. The Mets behind R.A. Dickey, who gave up just 3 hits over 8 innings. First pitcher to 12 wins this year. The Dodgers have lost 6 in a row. And looking for help. Matt Kemp on the DL. Andre Ethier day to day. The ebbs and flows of a baseball season. Well, a while ago, Bob, it looked like the Dodgers were going to win that division by 15 games. They're in second place now.
That's why we play 162 games. Peaks and valleys. Every team goes through them. Obviously, the good teams eliminate the length of the valleys and accentuate the length of the peaks, but everybody's going to go through them over the course of the season. I think the real wild card this year is the wild card itself. With the expanded playoffs, a lot more teams are going to feel like they're in a position to contend and could possibly see a lot more movement at the trade deadline this year than in years past.
Well, the Giants finally gave up a run. In fact, 5 of them last night. Mike Leake with his first career complete game as the Reds won 5-1. But the Giants have been incredible on the mound lately. Last night notwithstanding. Arizona hanging around. Rockies very disappointing, well under 500. To the count to Castro, the pitch fouled off. Speaking of the Diamondbacks, a 9-3 win in Milwaukee last night. Aaron Hill hit for another cycle. 2 cycles within 12 days. And that is the subject of today's Illinois Lottery Anything's Possible player. Aaron Hill is the Anything's Possible player, and it's brought to you by the Illinois Lottery, who each day make anything possible. So in the modern era, only one other guy had hit for the cycle twice in the same season. Babe Herman in 1931. And before that, you got to go back to the 1880s.
Yeah, Babe Herman had to wait 2 months for his second cycle. Aaron Hill didn't even have to wait 2 weeks.
The other one came against the Seattle Mariners. We should note Babe Ruth, Ty Cobb, Willie Mays, Tony Gwynn, Barry Bonds have combined for 0 cycles. There are some cycle haters out there who say, well, wait a minute. Just because you get one of the of each of the 4, I'd rather have 4 doubles or 4 triples, 4 homers. Yeah, but they're rare. That's what's cool about it. Ground ball. They'll try to turn it here. 6-4-3, and that'll end the inning. Haps been strong early on, leading 1-0 after three.
Here it is, a cool, slightly transformed, just a bit of a break from the norm.
Welcome to summer with Bud Light Lime. It's everything you love about Bud Light, with a twist of 100% natural lime flavor for ultimate refreshment. Bud Light Lime. Summer is calling.
Let eHarmony help you get out there this summer. We'll introduce you to people you have meaningful things in common with. Matches that are personalized just for you. Summer's the time when lots of new members join, so your chances of meeting someone special are even better. You can make a connection that lasts long after summer's gone. Review matches you could really click with for free now at eHarmony.com.
It's about time we made our homes work for us. So let's make our dryers do the ironing, have our fridges cater our parties, and tell our ranges to whip up dinner. Let's plug into summer savings before they're gone without wasting an ounce of energy with smart machines that turn housework into house play. More saving, more doing. That's the power of the Home Depot. Right now, save $600 on this Maytag French door refrigerator, just $15.98.
Juicy Johnsonville sausage, made with only premium cuts of pork since 1945. Johnsonville, sausage is all we do.
This is Mike. Mike's being healthy and chewing
like a man.
Introducing one-a-day VitaCraves for men. It's a gummy multivitamin with more vitamin B to convert food to energy and help Mike
do manly things like wrestle bears and take out the garbage.
New one-a-day VitaCraves for men.
We invite you to stay tuned for the seventh inning stretch brought to you by Captain Morgan. Raise your glass, always in moderation, to life, love, and loot.
The Red Baron, Rick Sutcliffe, will handle the stretch today, hanging out with Jason McLeod, Joe Boringer, and Shiraz Raymond from the Cubs front office. You got to get on him for wearing the sunglasses on the hat. I know that bothers you.
I don't expect Red to make any plays in this game today, so I'm going to give him a pass on that.
Four, five, and six for Houston. Astros leading 1-0. And strike one, 1-1. In that Cardinal game today, Pirates Cardinals, Andrew McCutchen left early. Apparently injured his left wrist, making a diving catch. Got any AC in there?
They've got as much as we do. Probably don't get a lot of breeze through the old scoreboard in center field, I wouldn't think.
Bogusevic held, and it's full 3-2.
Thank you.
Another 3-2 on the way. Bogusevic with the late swing just to hang in.
It's an emergency swing. Your fellow teammates will make fun of that swing when you get back to the bench, but very effective for Brian Bogusevic. He's going to force Garza to throw at least one more pitch here in the full count. A little better swing that time on a hanging breaking ball, but can't keep that one fair either.
Still 3-2 on Bogusevic. Chris Johnson is on deck. New pitch number 63 for Garza. Well, there's a fun website any baseball fan should check out on occasion. I know you've looked at it. Junkstats.com. Just interesting random statistical notes. There's one from the middle of May when Mike Minor of the Atlanta Braves had allowed 6 earned runs in 4 consecutive starts. So they went back, ball 4, to look at the longest such streak. Starting pitcher allowing 6 earned runs. They go back to 1918 when box score numbers were first, as they say, reliably tracked. Willie Blair in 1999 had 6 consecutive starts with Detroit in which he allowed at least 6 earned runs.
Wow.
13 homers over those 6 games. That's hard to do, to stay in a rotation when you allow that many earned runs and that many consecutive starts. That's a month.
Yeah, your argument is, well, I must be good. He keeps running me out there. My former manager Roger Craig was a 20-game loser for the Mets, and he said you've got to be pretty good to lose 20 games in the big leagues, because that means your manager thinks you have a chance to win and keeps sending you out there.
Well, there is an interesting guy on that list. Bob Gibson in 1964. And they used the baseball reference play index tool to find this stuff. Bob Gibson had 5 consecutive such starts, 1964. Tells you how hard a game it is. I would in a million years never have imagined that Bob Gibson had 5 consecutive bad starts.
Makes you wonder what in the world was going on during those 5 starts. Did he just not have it for that stretch of games? Was he tipping his pitches? Did he run up against some hyper-powered offenses? Tough to figure.
He had a 3.01 ERA that year. Another check on Bogusevic.
See, I like one of the other topics on junk stats myself. Just to waste a little time, one day they named the best Robert on each National League franchise and each American League franchise.
Love it.
Yeah. Now, it has to be some variation of Robert, either Rob or Robbie or Bob. But I thought that was pretty interesting. Let me take a look here. I don't remember right off the top of my head who the Cubs representative was. Bob Rush. And it appears that it was just based on wins above replacement. And Bob Rush, over the course of his Cubs career, had a 33.5 wins above replacement.
Wow.
Honorable mention, Bob O'Farrell, Bob Buell, and Bob Wicker. Let's see who the Disastros have on their list. Let me scroll down here a little bit.
Base hit into center for Johnson on a 1-2 offering. A couple of hits for the Astros today, behind in the count.
Yeah, not only the hits behind in the count, but also the just the inability for Matt Garza to put guys away when he gets to 2 strikes. You saw Bogusevic foul off a number of pitches. Well, that's a 95-mile-an-hour fastball just off of the inside corner, and he hit it like he knew it was coming. The Houston Astros best Bob was Bob Watson. Other notables, Bob Bruce, Bob Nepper, and Bob Aspromonte. I like that.
A little trouble here for Garza. Trailing 1-0, two on, nobody out. Another fun one in that same category you were talking about. The heaviest pitcher-batter matchups. Did you see that?
Yeah.
It started with LeVon Hernandez against Carlos Lee earlier this year. But the top 10, starting with number one, Jonathan Broxton against Adam Dunn, 585 Whoa. Combined pounds.
That's a lot of beef.
Ooh. Inside. CC Sabathia is on that list. Tied for ninth, Carlos Zambrano made the list when he faced Brad Eldred, 2005, 275 versus 290. What I want is the heaviest versus the lightest. Tony Campana against CC Sabathia, Jose Altuve against Jonathan Broxton, something like that. That's a great thing about baseball. How about John Roush? You get the tallest and one of the heaviest against one of the shortest and lightest. Bounce to Valbuena, knocked it down, steps on third, double play, 5-3. That's a big one. Good recovery by Valbuena. Castro's bounced into two double plays today.
Starlin's bounced into one. It's been a rough day for the Castros so far. Nice job by Valbuena to stay with it right there. That ball was hit hard to the opposite field. Able to knock it down, keep it in front, scoops with two hands, and then the strong throw across to get Castro at first base.
So runner at second, two outs, and it's Martinez who singled to lead off the third and has scored the only run. Well, because Garza has been unable to put guys away, he only has one strikeout, he has had to rely on his defense. That'll get into center. Coming around third is Johnson, and he will score, and it's 2-0. Little blooper over Darwin Barney. And Martinez had his 46th RBI.
Yeah, second consecutive at bat in the ball game for Martinez, where he gets an off-speed pitch up and out over the plate. He singled into center field back in the third inning. No damage done. However, this time an RBI on a breaking ball hit right back up the middle of the field again.
He's got 81 RBIs since coming up on July 30th of last year. And in that span, he's in the top 10 in the National League.
Well, obviously, Matt Garza, Giovanni Soto, Chris Bosio, the pitching coach, they sit down before the ball game, go over every hitter in this Astros lineup and how they want to attack them. But I tell you, if the idea is to attack Martinez with breaking balls, I think their theory is flawed. He showed you his approach at the plate in his first at bat of the ball game, the flat bat, and then he raises it back up and then he lowers it down again. A lot of movement, should be susceptible to good fastballs up and in. But he's pounded two off-speed pitches back up the middle.
Two to the count. Dale Swaim announced earlier today Chris Volstead will come back from AAA Iowa, and he'll get the start in Ryan Dempster's spot Tuesday night in Atlanta. Big time struggle for Volstead with the Cubs, but a lot better at Iowa's last few times out. A couple of losses, but an ERA in the threes. So he'll be back on Tuesday. Face a team he's faced a lot in the past. Out of the left center, DeJesus plays it on the bounce. His throw will come into Castro. They've got Martinez caught between second and third, and he's an easy out. So he runs into the third out, but he knocked in a run. It's 2-0.
The inspiring taste of McDonald's new Spicy Chicken McBites. Poppable pieces of tender chicken breast, seasoned with just the right amount of spice, but just for a limited time. Right now, grab a snack size for only $1. New Spicy Chicken McBites. The simple joy of spicy perfection.
Mesothelioma victims and their loved ones may be entitled to a cash award from the $18 billion in asbestos trust funds, and you do not have to file a lawsuit. If diagnosed with mesothelioma or lung cancer caused by exposure to asbestos, call the number on your screen now. Even if a loved one had mesothelioma or asbestos lung cancer and has passed, your family may still be entitled to a cash award. Mesothelioma is a rare cancer caused by exposure to asbestos. Many victims worked in the Navy or in shipyards, mills, carpentry, roofing, insulation, construction, or automotive industries. For over 30 years, our legal team has successfully helped thousands of victims and families. Time is limited. You do not have to file a lawsuit. If you or a loved one has been diagnosed with mesothelioma or lung cancer caused by exposure to asbestos, please call 1-800-296-1976 now. That's 1-800-296-1976.
This copyrighted telecast is presented by authority of the Chicago Cubs and may not be reproduced or retransmitted in any form. And the accounts and descriptions of this game may not be disseminated without the express written consent of the Chicago Cubs.
2-0 Astros as we head for the bottom half of the fourth inning. It'll be Rizzo, Soriano, LeHaire, and hopefully others for the Cubs. Not a great base running play here by J.D. Martinez. Play is right in front of him as you see DeJesus play it on a hop. He hustles it back in quickly to Starlin Castro, and right there is J.D. Ramirez in no man's land. Good relay for the final out of the inning.
Once he got caught in no man's land, I think most managers would rather have you make the out trying to advance. Is that one blasted to center by Rizzo? Just missed it as Schaefer makes a grab on the warning track, something the Cubs, Dave McKay, talked to their guys about in spring training, Bob. Once you go, you're going to get caught, go. Get thrown out at third, not at second.
Well, and unlike lower levels of baseball, rarely are rundowns messed up in the big leagues.
Right.
Rarely. It happens occasionally, but usually if you get a runner caught between base, he's out. So you might as well keep going and hope for an errant throw to third base or a bobble by the third baseman, because you are going to be out. I just can't figure out where J.D. Martinez thought he was going to go. Play was right in front of him. DeJesus' momentum was carrying him toward third base. Very little chance of advancing.
The only thing I can think of, even from our vantage point, looked like that ball might get past him. It didn't. And once it didn't, he was, as you say, a dead duck. That one out in the left center for Soriano, hustling around first. Big turn. He's going to stop with a single. Meet the team and picnic on the outfield grass at Wrigley Field after the Cubs play the Diamondbacks on July 15th. When Chicago Cubs Charities presents Picnic for a Purpose, presented by Bank of America. Enjoy a picnic dinner on in the outfield, meet current Cub players and coaches, and take home a Cubs picnic blanket, all while benefiting the community. For more information and to purchase tickets, visit Cubs.com.
I still think the Shedd Aquarium ought to have a similar event, call it Picnic with a Porpoise.
Just don't probably arrange that.
Just don't serve seafood, that's all.
Right. Quickly 0-2 on LaHare.
We talked about Brian LaHare and the fact that he hasn't been facing a lot of lefties recently, and I tell you, you can think yourself into a slump as a left-handed hitter facing a left-handed pitcher. You figure at some point I'm going to see breaking pitches from this guy. That's what left-handed pitchers do to left-handed hitters. Breaking ball right there, fouled out. But this at bat started with three straight fastballs. Looked like Brian LaHare was trying to think along with the left-handed Jay Happ, looking for that breaking pitch early in the count, and didn't get it this time.
Pretty drastic difference. Bob, I know we've talked about it this year, but it bears repeating. You know, Afonso Soriano last year may not have run quite as hard, knowing that this was probably going to be a single. You can tell his knees are just really bothering him. Looks like it hurts to stop. But he busted his tail out of the box and was a third of the way to second base.
He's a different looking player this year, both offensively and defensively. I mean, we cannot overstate how much of an improvement he has made defensively in left field this year. He is he's beyond serviceable. I don't panic anymore when I see balls go to left field. He's eliminated the hop. He's not afraid of the wall anymore. And a lot of the credit has to go to the guy standing right there in foul territory next to him, Dave McKay. I mean, Soriano was a pet project for Dave McKay from the first day of spring training down in Mesa, Arizona. A renewed emphasis on the fundamental drills, getting Fonzie to concentrate on doing things the right way, regardless of what the situation is. Do what you're supposed to do, and more often than not, things are going to come out okay.
Well, he's an all-star coach because he was on Tony La Russa's staff last year, but he's an all-star coach.
Period. Yeah.
He deserves to be there.
Yep. And all he asks of his players is the desire to want to be better, try to be better. You can always improve some aspect of your game. Don't ever be content.
Driving attempt by Lee. Nice play by Moore. Happ covering. It'll go 4-1 to get LaHare. Two away.
LaHare tries to take advantage of that hole on the right side, gets it past a diving El Caballo, but Scott Moore was shaded a little bit toward that hole on the right side, and Jay Happ quickly got off the mound to cover the bag.
Change up missed low to Soto, singled in his first at bat.
And that single in his first at bat was on the very first delivery from Jay Happ, a fastball, and Soto was all over it. So this time around, two changeups to start the sequence.
Heater low.
Ball
left him on four. Two on, two down, the pitch to Darwin Barney. That's a called strike.
It's one of the tougher situations for any third base coach, but especially Pat Listash right now. We've talked about Soriano. He has bad knees out there at second base. You have to take that into consideration should there be a base hit to the outfield, the strength of the arms of the outfielders. Where are you at in the ball game? What's the score of the ball game? Who's in the on deck circle? All those things have to be pondered before the ball is put into play. And all you ask for as a third base coach is run as hard as you can. I'll watch the play, I'll watch the ball, and I'll determine whether you should go home or not. All I ask of you is to run as hard as you can. But that being said, Pat Listash may have to throw up the stop sign a little sooner with Soriano than he might with another Cubs base runner because of that bad knee. We saw how long it took Soriano to slow down after rounding first base. Well, the same thing would happen at third.
Diving stop, Lowry, backhand flip. At second, what a play on both ends. Scott Moore had to dig the throw out of the dirt as the Astros get out of the inning. The Cubs strand a couple on a defensive gem here by the double play combo. Still 2-0.
Do your home projects take forever? Time is money. And switching back and forth between drill bits and driver heads takes even longer. Stop wasting time. Bo Ryle's here for the Halftime Drill Driver. The innovative new way to drill, flip, and drive in only 5 seconds. You'll never have to change a bit in the middle of a job again. Halftime works with the tools that you already have, making them better than before. Watch. Just select two different size bits, drill your pilot hole, flip the pivot arm, then drive in any screw, nut, or fastener. It takes the hard work out of any job. And you can go from drilling to driving, Phillips to flat, any combination for any task. Avoid split wood. This countersink creates recessed pilot holes for professionally finished results. Halftime is perfect for do-it-yourselfers, contractors, even first-time fixer-uppers. Save money. The breakthrough, our patent-pending swivel head that flips and locks, giving you precision performance from drilling to driving in seconds. Even this time-consuming project that normally takes days to build was completed in half the time. Sound those wedding bells. Changing bits on a ladder can be difficult and dangerous. With Halftime, it's so easy. You just flip and you never drop a bit. During my introductory offer, you get the Halftime Drill Driver for only $19.95. I'll even include four different Phillips heads, four flat, and four drill bits, no charge. Call now and receive this durable carry case, perfect for the utility drawer or toolbox, free. But I'm not stopping there. Call or click right this minute and get a second complete set free. Just pay separate processing and handling. That way you can share one and keep one for yourself. Yep, you get it all for the low, low price of just $19.95. Call now.
To order Halftime Drill Driver for $19.95 plus processing and handling, call 1-800-793-9204 or log on to gethalftime.com.
The fifth inning is brought to you by Fifth Third Bank, the Curious Bank. Member FDIC. Astros out hitting the Cubs 7-2 and leading 2-0. Happ, Schaefer, and Lowry here in the fifth. Hey. Line in the left and a base hit. Looks like Daniel Hudson of the Diamondbacks is headed for Tommy John surgery. My friend Steve Gilbert from MLB.com tweeting that Dr. Yoakum gave a second opinion and confirmed that they're going to have that elbow reconstructed. Wade Miley looks for his 10th win tonight. He was impressive against the Cubs last weekend. Diamondbacks are in Milwaukee.
The Diamondbacks, one of those teams we were perhaps talking about earlier in the game. If they feel like they've got a chance to make the postseason, they may be looking to add some pitching help at the deadline.
First inning grand slam for the Pedro Alvarez, and the Pirates beat the Cardinals 7-3. Bucks have won four in a row. Temperature reached 103 at Busch Stadium. That's golfed high in the air to right field, where LeHaire, with the glasses on, will make the catch. One away.
It's time for our Xfinity catcher profile, protecting home for the Astros. Not Brian LeHaire. We'll come back to it in a moment, having some technical difficulties there. You're going to love this one, though.
I can't wait. That's what they call a tease in the business. Here's Lowry, 0 for 2. Big defensive play in this game. He chops a bunt, and Garza slips. Everybody's safe. That'll be a hit for Lowry.
Matt Garza went down hard as he came off the mound to field this bunt that was chopped. The right foot went out from under him, fell hard on his right arm. Take another look at it from this angle. Remember, the field was resodded while the Cubs were gone. The turf maybe hasn't taken root as much as it will. They're going to give him an opportunity to throw a couple of warm-up pitches here. Might have just had the wind knocked out of him there.
Gave Mark O'Neill the thumbs up.
Yeah, he went to plant with that right foot, and it just slid right out from underneath him.
So he'll face Lee with two on and one out. Lee is 1-for-6 in the series with a double and 5 groundouts. Garza can get another one of those ground balls here. Might be his third double play ball, and it'll get him out of the inning. Swing and a miss. Three career homers for Lee at Wrigley Field. Only Adam Dunn and Albert Pujols among active opponents have more. That get Gio
somewhere on the right arm. Almost always in an unprotected area. Watch the right arm of Giovanni Soto. Man, right off the forearm, just in front of the elbow. Fortunately, just a glancing blow. It's all part of the job.
Ground ball, Garza can't get it, but it's right to Barney. Little stumble. What a throw. Off balance, to say the very least, to get the 4-3 double play, and the inning comes to an end.
Here it is, a cool, slightly transformed, just a bit of a break from the norm.
Welcome to summer with Bud Light Lime. It's everything you love about Bud Light, with a twist of 100% natural lime flavor for ultimate refreshment. Bud Light Lime. Summer is calling.
This is Mike. Mike's being healthy and chewing
like a man.
Introducing One-A-Day Vitacraves for Men. It's a gummy multivitamin with more vitamin B to convert food to energy and help Mike
do manly things like wrestle bears and take out the garbage.
New One-A-Day Vitacraves for Men.
Every Domino's sandwich is made fresh with only our best ingredients.
They're not simply toasted. They're baked all the way through our pizza oven.
This isn't just an oven. It's our secret ingredient.
This is a 300,000 BTU flavor fusing monster.
I think he's gone a little crazy with that oven.
The oven's special, but it's not as amazing as our Philly cheesesteak or chicken mango habanero sandwiches.
It makes my mouth water right now, actually.
Order any of our oven-baked sandwiches or medium two-topping pizzas. Choose any two for just $5.99 each.
With the Capital One Cash Rewards card, you get a 50% annual bonus. And everyone likes 50% more cash. Well, except her. But I'm about to change that.
Every little baby wants 50% more cash.
Fine, you try.
The Capital One Cash Rewards card. The card for people who want 50% more cash.
What's in your wallet? What's in your...
The Cubs take on the Braves in Atlanta, Wednesday night at 7 East.
Fifth inning is brought to you by Fifth Third Bank, the curious bank, member FDIC.
2-0 Houston. Seems pretty good defense here over the last couple of half innings. Jed Lowry and Scott Moore teaming up in the bottom of the fourth. And how about this double play turn by Darwin Barney?
Smooth as burlap. Ball gets by Matt Garza, kind of deflected it a little bit. Barney stumbles on his way to second base, has enough body control to still make the throw on to Anthony Rizzo to complete the double play. Yeah, you might not put it on a highlight video, but effective nonetheless.
Cubs have turned three double plays today. Valbuena, Garza, DeJesus here in the fifth. Jay Happ looking for his first win on the road. 0-3 with a 736 in five road starts coming in.
They have with a little more velocity, but very similar in style to the man sitting right to your left, partner, Jim DeShays, on the Astros TV telecast. He was a guy that pitched very effectively across the top of the strike zone with a very mediocre fastball in the mid to upper 80s, but always elevated it just a little bit higher than a hitter could handle.
Right on cue. Two of our favorites, JD on the left, Bill Brown on the right. I'd asked to borrow their duct tape, but I think they used all of it. Three and one.
That's a high-tech equipment, but got to use good old-fashioned duct tape to hold it all in place.
Ball four. Who knew when they built that sign that said stairs that they would be used for shade?
3 sack bunts on the season for Matt Garza. That's what Dale Swain's going to ask him to do in this situation. And we have seen Matt pull the bat back and swing away when those corner infielders charge hard. So not a given that he's going to try to put down a bunt, but you would certainly expect it.
Trying to be cute and say he was trying to make it an even dozen, but he's looking for his 12th. Let's make it simple. Nice. That's it down, and this will be number 12. Goes 3-4. Time for the Chevy Youth Baseball League of the Game. Today we want to recognize Chevrolet of Naperville for its support of the Naperville Renegades. Chevrolet of Naperville and your Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Chevy dealers support leagues and young ball players in their communities through the Chevy Youth Baseball Program. From the big leagues to the youth leagues, Chevy is truly the official vehicle of baseball. Runner at second, one out. Couple of shots to get Valbuena to the plate as DeJesus has struck out and walked. Down by Johnson, and he'll get the out at first. So two away. Starlin, who has walked and hit into a 6-4-3 double play.
Average stands at 296 with his 0-for-1 in the ball game today. We've talked about it in the past. Seems like every time he gets close to or under 300, he goes on a tear.
Hydrate, young man. Has Cubs wristbands on.
Mm-hmm.
Although we call them forearm bands for him.
Chug, chug, chug.
Lined into right. Valbuena coming home. He will score 2-1. RBI single for Castro. Give him 40 RBIs on the year, and the Cubs are on the board.
Take what they give you. Nice piece of hitting by Starlin. Castro gets a breaking ball off the plate away, stays right on it, lines it cleanly into right field. With two outs in the inning, Luis Valbuena off on contact. He'll score easily as El Caballo cuts that one off.
Starlin up to a 298 with that RBI single. to see that leadoff walk come back and score. Give Garza half an RBI there for the sack bunt, getting Valbuena into scoring position in the first place. Rizzo at the plate, the throw to first.
A couple different schools of thought here, Len. Number one, you'd like to leave that hole on the right side of the field for Anthony Rizzo to try to shoot one through there for a base hit. But the other side of the coin is, if Starlin Castro could get a jump and steal his way into scoring position, then Anthony Rizzo would possibly have an RBI situation to tie this game up.
High towering fly deep to right. Gone! His first as a Cub. And they lead 3-2. Career. How about both homers have come off lefties? John Lannon was the victim last year. Just like that, the Cubs lead this game.
Rizzo narrowly missed a home run back in the fourth inning when he led off with that drive to straightaway center field. No doubt about this one. I mean, what little bit of wind there is here this afternoon continues to blow in from right field out of the east, but didn't affect that one in the least.
Still buzzing after that towering shot. Swing and a miss to end the inning. Castro with a two-out RBI single, make it 2-1, and then Anthony Rizzo blast off.
You met the neighbors of late night? Liz Lemon.
I'm your worst nightmare is who I is.
Bender.
If only I didn't have so much cork in my Dunkin' Dunk.
Frank.
Make some cash.
Welcome to the neighborhood. That's what we call a block party. Late nights on WGN America.
Everyone in this family loves free stuff, like these earmuffs from the air show.
Did you tell about the free stuff?
At Choice Hotels, two stays pays. Stay two separate times and earn a free $50 gift card for gas, dining, or shopping. Book now at choicehotels.com.
Hebrew National hot dogs are so amazingly good, you'll get lost in an all-beef hot dog world. What was I supposed to wish for? Why am I wearing a bow tie? Where did I leave my bicycle? After all, when you're enjoying the beefiest, juiciest bite of pure kosher beef, nothing else matters. Goodness gracious, that's kosher. With no fillers, byproducts, artificial flavors, or colors. Hebrew National, the better than a hot dog hot dog.
I do that too.
You've tried these?
No, just seeing how they're holding up.
It's kind of like visiting old friends.
Some of them a little older than others.
You know, Wendy's has the summer berry salad. It's made fresh every day.
It is so good.
Why settle when Wendy's Berry Almond Chicken Salad is made with fresh, hand-cut strawberries, plump blueberries. Fresh tastes, made fresh, every day. That's Wendy's way.
Now that's better.
We're testing new Degree, the only antiperspirant activated directly by movement.
Activating protection, Bear!
The more you move, the more it works. New long-lasting Degree with motion sense.
Help me!
Keep running.
Let's take a look at our Ford upcoming Cubs schedule. Wrap up this series in a homestand tomorrow afternoon. Then off to Atlanta, Cubs and Braves, Monday through Thursday night. And then in New York next weekend to end the first half. Ford, manufacturers of more fuel-efficient vehicles than any other brand. Check them out at your local Ford store or online at localfordstores.com. Anthony Rizzo with a booming two-run go-ahead homer. And the Cubs have their first lead today, 3-2. Only a few Lakeview area residents taking a late afternoon siesta, awakened by a big thud and some loud cheers. Inside corner to Bogusevic. Now 2-1. Matt Garza has dealt with a lot of base runners today, but benefited from three double play balls. He's given up 9 hits. He's walked 2. That's 11 base runners through 5. Now 3-1. Garza ready, the wind and the payoff delivery. Bounced foul.
And this is where the pitch count has really climbed today for Matt Garza after getting the 2 strikes on a number of these Astro hitters. They just continue to foul pitch after pitch into the stands and foul territory.
Up in a shallow left. Castro with a smart play saw Soriano was going to have an issue getting there, so he just called for it. It looked like Soriano did get there, but Castro took it anyway, and they discuss. Let's step aside and see what's coming up on WGN.
Head over to Facebook.com/30Rock for an inside look at America's best show. And be sure to watch 30 Rock weekdays at 6 East, 3 West, right here on WGN America.
Johnson's 2-for-2 with a run. Was 0-for-12 coming in. Making his 70th start at third base this season. And a fastball misses low and outside. Slider strike. Left-hander Scott Main is up. Earlier this week, he got his first major league win. That guy bobbled it a couple of times, but eventually made the grab.
One.
Two. Got it.
Oh. Oh. Almost tried to do too much with that play.
It's full 3-2. Steven Strasburg had to leave his start against the Braves today after three innings. They're saying due to heat exhaustion. It was 104 at game time in Atlanta. Strasburg made nearly 70 pitches, 67 pitches in three innings. Mm. Braves lead that game 7-2. They're in the sixth. And he walked him.
No, we started before. We're going to finish it this time, I promise. Time for our Xfinity catcher profile. Only 2 years as a catcher for Craig Biggio for the Astros. He was the 89 Silver Slugger as a catcher. Yogi Berra, love his quote on Craig Biggio. Short catchers are better because they don't have to stand up as far. Craig Biggio finished his career with 3,060 hits, 281 career hitter, 414 stolen bases.
It's going to be it for Matt Garza, who gets a nice hand. Scott Main coming on, 3-2 Cubs.
You can never have too much of a good thing. The unlimited soup, salad, and breadsticks lunch at Olive Garden, just $6.95. Fresh, crisp salad made when you order it. Four soups made fresh daily. Baked breadsticks right out of the oven. Just $6.95 for a limited time.
This is Mike. Mike's being healthy and chewing like a man. Introducing One-A-Day VitaCraves for Men. It's a gummy multivitamin with more vitamin B to convert food to energy and help Mike
do manly things like wrestle bears and take out the garbage.
New One-A-Day VitaCraves for Men.
Agents, say hello to the biggest hailstone in U.S. history.
Oh, that'll leave a dent.
Which is exactly why we educate people about comprehensive coverage.
Yep, the right choice now can pay off later.
Looks like a bowling ball.
Yeah.
No!
Agents, say hello to the second biggest hailstone in U.S. history.
We are insurance.
We are farmers. Bum, ba, da, bum, 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 bum.
Every Domino's sandwich is made fresh with only our best ingredients.
They're not simply toasted. They're baked all the way through our pizza oven.
This isn't just an oven. It's our secret ingredient.
This is a 300,000 BTU flavor-fusing monster.
I think he's gone a little crazy with that oven. The oven's special, but it's not as amazing as our Philly cheesesteak or chicken mango habanero sandwiches.
It makes my mouth water right now, actually.
Order any of our oven-baked